दिस इज मिस्टर एम स्वामीदास वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मल्लारेड्डी इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग मैसामगुड़ा दूलपल्ली हैदराबाद इंडिया. गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव ए प्रेजेंटेशन on data link layer. Data link layer, so ISO OSI reference model has 7 layers. One is physical layer, second one is data link layer, network layer, third one, fourth one transport layer, fifth one session layer, presentation layer and the application layer. Each layer which provides the functionality and each layer provides its own functionality and provides the services to the upper layer. So physical layer, it deals with the actual transmission of the data which will be represented in zeros and ones is called what, the physical layer. And data link layer, which accepts the input from the physical layer and make the information into frames, is called what, data link layer. And network layer, network layer, it receives the data from data link layer and makes them into the form of packets is called what, network layer. Packet, it is a group of frames is called what, packet. And the transport layer, it is the heart of the ISO OSI reference model, in which one network, one system to the another system, which will be forwarding the packets, the source to the destination in among the hosts, done by the transport layer. And the three upper layers, session layer, presentation layer and the application layer, are called what, software layer. Session layer, it is a synchronization and making the sessions, and presentation layer, presenting the information and security will be provided in the presentation. And the application layer, which provides the applications like email and chatting and other applications. So this is the ISO OSI reference model. Data link layer, it is the second layer, is called what, data link layer in ISO OSI reference model. It is one of the most important layer in the layered architecture. The data link layer, which takes the information from the physical layer and makes the information into the form of frames, is called what, data link layer. Data link layer, it is directly point to point broadcasting system in the same link. The data link layer is converting the data into signal bits and send over the hardware and receive the other end. It picks the hardware and information received signal in the form of bits. The recognizing the frame format and the information with the data link layer provides the information to the upper layer, network layer, in the form of packets. It receives the data from the data link layer and the network layer, it makes the information into the form of packets, right? So the data link layer has two sub layers. One is called logical link control, it is, and another one is media access control. Logical access control, it deals with the protocols. Protocol is called what, set of rules is called what, protocol. The flow control, error control, it is the responsibility and the function of the logical link control. And media access control, it is the actual control of the media and the functionality of the data link layer. It provides the services to the network layer by frames. The frames are a group of frames is called what, packet. Data link layer takes the information from physical layer and makes the information into the form of frames. Frame, it is a collection of bits. And the network layer, it takes the data from data link layer and makes the information into the form of packets. What is mean by packet? Packet, it is a group of frames is called what, packet. So in a packet, it encapsulates the frames and it sends the information to the hardware end to end. The data link layer picks the signal and assembles them into the frames is called what, the data link layer. and addressing. So addressing, synchronization, error control, flow control and multi access, these are the functions. Addressing, it is data link layer, it is the layer 2 in the hierarchy. It is encoded into the hardware time of manufacturing. It is unique hardware address, unique on the link and encoded into hardware at the time of manufacturing is called what? Address. It is addressing the information by data link layer. And synchronization. Synchronization is the time of the data frames are sent from one system to another system. Both machines are synchronized. The order in which the data transfer from sender to the receiver in the same order is called what? Synchronization. And error control. Error control, it is the bits are flipped into encoded and actual data being sent to the in the network, so that the information it provides error reporting to the sender. And flow control. Flow control, the speed, the capacity of the data flow from between two machines is called what? Flow control. And multi-access control, and the multi-access when sharing the data to the multiple systems is called what? Multi-access control. And data link layer, it is a layer 2 in the ISO OSI reference model. It determines, it takes the data from physical layer and make them into the frames. It deals with the two things. One is called CRC and another one is ARQ. CRC is called what? It regulates the flow of the frames in the two machines and it performs the link layer management. Cyclic redundancy check, it is the error detection code used in the digital networks and storage devices and detect accidental changes to the raw data. Cyclic redundancy check, it is a checking to detect any errors in the code which are identified by cyclic redundancy code. And automatic repeat request, when there is an error in the frame while transferring the data from machine to machine, if there is an error from sender, it will be recognized from receiver to the sender saying that there is an error. Again repeating the same message, that if there is an error, it will be repeating the same message with the transmission. It uses the acknowledgement, negative acknowledgement and timeout, and due to these unreliable communication link, these reasons, automatic repeat request is also available. And hop, it is a system, the distance between the two systems are connected, and sending the information from network to network, host to host is called what? Hop. And you can see here the packets, and the physical layer is the actual representation of the information, zeros and ones, and a data link layer which accepts the zeros and ones and make them into the frames, and which provides the services to the upper layer, network layer, into packets. So here you can see this is a whole A system and this is the B system. A system is sending the information to the B system. Here three layers are involving. One is the physical layer entity, second one is the data link layer entity, third one is the network layer entity. Physical layer is making the information zeros and ones. Actual transmission of the data, how much voltage takes to represent one and how much voltage takes to represent zero. And the data link layer, layer 2, its function is, it receives the data from physical layer and makes the information into frames. Frame, it is called a group of bits is called what? Frame. For example, 8 bits is a frame, 16 bits is a frame, right? Network, it is a group of frames is called what? Packet, right? So this from A to B system, the information from layer 2 to layer 2, it is the frame communication. In the upper layer, the packet communication from A system to B system in the network layer. So this end-to-end connection from hop to hop, system to system, the data, how it will be transmitted in a network communication. So the 1 to 2 data, it will be transferred, and this 2 to 3 system, it will be transferred the frames, 2, 3 to 4 and 4 to 5. Finally, it will be reaching to the end, and there will be an acknowledgement that the frames are received without any problem. And if there is a delay or error, it will be sending. There will be two types of acknowledgement. That is, acknowledgement if received safely, and if negative acknowledgement if timed out, and there will be error in the frames. So that again, the sender will resend the information of the same information to the end-to-end system, right? So here the acknowledgement goes in the 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 4, and 4 to 5. So this is the diagram which represents how the data communication frames are communicated from end-to-end connectivity. There will be two types of acknowledgments. One is the positive acknowledgments and the negative acknowledgement. So the data link layer, it is the layer 2, which node to node, the bits are delivered the order in which the sender will send to the receiver, the same order it will be transmitted. And the receiver will receive the same order of the information sent by the sender. And rigid interface between host to node, the communication policy, and ISO OSI reference model, and it is a simplified model. So the you can see the data link layer from frames in the node 2. So node 1 to node 2, there is a communication in the host A to host B. That is the layered architecture. Layer 1 is the physical layer, layer 2 is the data link layer, layer 3 is the network layer, layer 4 is the transport layer. Transport layer, end-to-end connectivity from between two hosts, is the layer 2. The frame communication assumes that the information sending from host to host, an infinite supply of the messages. The node constructs a frame, a single packet message, and checksum automatically appended at the hardware, and the protocol developing increasing the complexity. It helps the students to understand the data link layer issues. And so here the basic elements of ARQ and packet receiving packets are in sequence. So the transmitter and the receiver, A station and B station. A station will send the information to the B station. So the packets are receiving packets are a group of frames with the packets are with the receiving in the same order of the message communicated from A station to B station, and the control of the packets from A station to B station. If it is the packets are in the sequence, and the cyclic redundancy check, it checks that where there are no errors, and checksum is correct means that it will send the positive acknowledgement. If not, it will send the negative acknowledgement. So cyclic redundancy check and information packets and header, these are the used. And controlling the frames, there are two things. One is the cyclic redundancy check, which is used for detecting the errors, and header, which identifies the messages order in which the communication from the host to host in the network layer. And you can see the physical layer, the ones and zeros representation actual transmission of the data signal, and the data link layer signal from the host to host, how much the bits group of bits, information, acknowledgement, sequence and kind. The actual information of the data and acknowledgement and the sequence of the information and kind. So this and buffer, it contains a group of packets, right? So this is a and the services of data link layer are, there are six services. One is framing and link access, and reliable delivery and flow control, error detection, error correction, off duplex and full duplex communications. So services of the data link layer, framing and data link access and reliability delivery, flow control, error detection, error control, off duplex and full duplex communications. The framing and link access. Frame, it is a collection of bits, is called what? Frame. It provides the sender to send the information bits in a meaningful way to the receiver. The frames are, the two systems are in the networking, the physical connectivity, or there will be wireless connectivity. The station sends and It looks the special sequence of messages in the frame that is dot frame delimiter and where the end delimiter, right? So almost the all the links of the protocols are encapsulating each layer with a link and onto the link to the another host to host, and the frames is a collection of bits, and network layer it is a collection of packets. It deals with the collection of packets with the significant information to the end-to-end connectivity. And so the data framing in data link layer, the here you can see the data from upper layer. So here data from upper layer insufficient. If it is insufficient information, so the information which will be represented into frame formats, one is flag header and the actual data, and trailer is added and flag it will be added. The information from host to host, it will be from one host to another host. The in the layer 2 communication, the actual information is the first one representation 00 and the first frame representation, and the actual data extra 2 bits are added. That is, the bits are represented in bold letters, right? 0 and 0, and this will be sent. So the unstuffed data and this receiving, while it will be unstuffed and the 2 bits are removed, and it will take the actual information. So this is the frame data link layer. The frame, it is the flag header and the actual data with the stuffed and trailer and flag, right? And the reliability delivery. Reliability delivery is a data link layer most reliability delivery over the which has error rate, and it can be corrected and it is linked and retransmit to the data. And the data link layer provides a mechanism to detect one or more errors. And the link layer, it is a reliable service each which across the link, and the reliability delivery, it has error control, sequence control, loss control and duplication control. Error control, if there is an error, it will be controlled, identified and it will be rectified. And the sequence, or the order in which the frames are arrived and sent from host to host, the loss of control and the duplication control. So if there is any duplication, and that also it will be controlled. The reliability delivery is a mechanism over the host to host. The error rate can be corrected and errors occurring, and retransmit the frames which are errors happen, and it provides a mechanism to detect the error control and error control and error detection and resending the correct information, retransmitting the correct information. It is the reliability delivery. Ensures that it is an acknowledged service from host to host. And the flow control. Flow control, it is a technique for working, communicating each other, is called what? Flow control. Flow control restricting the frames and acknowledging from the server, the receiver, is called what? The flow control. Flow control, it is a process of managing the rate between the two nodes and preventing fast sender and overcoming the slow receiver. It is a synchronizing the frames, right? If he is sending the very fastly, the receiver is receiving the very slowly, means there will be no synchronization. This is a flow control data communication. The sender in which sending the information, the same the receiver is receiving the information. So for example, the flow control, for example, so the controlling the data and congestion has actually occurred. And the categories of the flow control, one is stop and wait and another sliding window protocol. So stop and wait and send one frame at a time, it is called what? Stop and wait. And sliding window protocol, send several frames at a time, is called what? Sliding window protocol. And flow control, it deals with the speed match with the sender and the receiver. There are two approaches for the flow control, and feedback based flow control and rate based flow control. Feedback based flow control, sender sends the information to the receiver. Receiver receiving the information and telling that the same order, the time taken to send and receiving controlled synchronously, managed synchronous feedback. So the sender sending one frame and the receiver receiving the frame, and in order the sender sending and receiver receiving is controlled, a feedback is there. And the rate based flow control, it is a control mechanism that using feedback from the receiver is called what? Rate based flow control. It is transmitting the data without using feedback, and the rate in which the sender is sending, the rate in which the receiver is receiving is called what? Rate based flow control. Various four flow control schemes used in the data link layer, which is well defined rules, so the sender may transmit the messages and probiting the frames until it has a permission either implicitly or explicitly. So the data link layer error detection control technique ensures that the frames, bit streams, data transmitted from the source to destination at an extent of accuracy is called what? Error detection. It is a process of detecting the errors by using frame check sequence and parity check calculation or cyclic redundancy check. These are the mechanisms used for error detection methods. So frame check sequence, frames are arrival in a sequence, and parity, there will be a parity in the frame. By knowing the parity, it will identify whether there is an error or not. And cyclic redundancy check, it is also a method for detecting the errors. And error detections are error detection deciding that the data is correct or is not correct, is an original message or not. Error detection, it is a concept of redundancy, and adding extra bits detecting the errors at the destination. And error detection methods are VRC and LRC, CRC and checksum. So VRC, it is a vertical redundancy check. It is a bit added each data unit, and it is an even parity or odd parity, and this is called what? Vertical redundancy check. And detecting the errors and longitudinal redundancy check, it is a parity check. It is a even or odd is calculated in each column, and 32 bit data plus 8 bit redundancy data transmitted to the receiver. The advantages of the two methods, that is vertical redundancy check and longitudinal redundancy check, is the advantages of the using of the methods is data computed and appended original data, detecting the errors referred to the checksum and cyclic redundancy check. Cyclic redundancy check, it is a property that it checks the errors the receiver if there is a frame which has damaged the and having the errors, checksum is identified whether the checksum is incorrect, and again the receiver asks the sender to send the message, retransmit the message. So the fifth one is the error correction. Error correction, it is one of the most important technique in the data link layer. Ensures that the frames and bits are transmitted from source to destination, and error after correcting the data lost of the information bits, techniques are available which retransmitting the frames, and errors are detected and errors are corrected with accuracy, right? And single bit error, if this is a sender will send the message here, the 4 0 0 1 0, and the receiver receiving 4 0 1 0 1 0. Here the sender is sending the 0 at the fifth location, the receiver is receiving the one location. It is changed, 0 is changed to 1 in the receiver, so that it will be single bit error and it will be corrected with a serial transmission. And single bit errors happen in parallel transmission. And so the half duplex and full duplex communication, hub, and there is a system, there will be two devices, systems are connected one with another. And half duplex communication, it is called what? One way communication. Either the sender will send to the receiver or receiver will send to the sender, it's called what? Half duplex communication. And full duplex communication, sender and receiver will change one, either sender will send to receiver and receiver will send to sender in the bidirectional, it is called what? Full duplex. Half duplex, it is a unidirectional communication flow. It is called what? Half duplex communication. The data link layer provides a mechanism to detect one or more errors. Half duplex communication or full duplex communication, both nodes are transmit the data at the same time. Half duplex mode is one can transmit the data at the same time, and full duplex communication capable of bidirectional network data flow in the same time. It is called what? Full duplex. Half duplex can only one direction, is called what? Half duplex communication, right? For example, if we see the in olden days, the railway signaling, there will be mobile phones are available. The mobile phone, he will send some information hotspot and so walkie talkie and send over like that. The receiver will receive and he will send over. Okay, like that it will be there. It is used in the half duplex communication devices in the railway, and it's also used in the police traffic control systems. And full duplex controls are mode are nowadays everybody using the mobile phones. Either the sender and receiver will communicate each other in a bi-directional way, right? This is the full duplex. And another example of half duplex is, it is a one way traffic is called what? Half duplex. And full duplex, it is a bi-directional way of the traffic, is called what? Full duplex, right? And so the data link layer takes the data and frames and make them into the frame packets in the network layer. The source and the destination addresses are as well defined, and detecting and controlling transmission of the errors. So the further the data link layer, medium access control and logical link layer. The 7-layer ISO OSI reference model, physical layer, data link layer, and the network layer, right? These 3 layers are hardware layers, and the other 3 layers are the software layers, and the transportation layer is the heart of the ISO OSI reference model, which is communicating from hop to hops, data transmission of moving the packets from end to end, packets in the network to network, without any collisions, without any problems. And so the network physical layer, data link layer, and the network layer. So the physical layer, actual transmission of the data, zeros and ones, how much voltage it takes to represent zero, how much voltage it takes to represent one. Data link layer, it takes the information from the physical layer and make them into the frames. And the network layer, it takes the data from the data link layer and make them into the packets. Packet, it is a group of frames. Frame, it is a group of bits, right? End to end connectivity in the layer 2, frames and frames. And the data link layer, you can see the physical layer, the information is in the layer 1 representing 10111, and it will be a sequence of frames, right? And address. So this is a frame format. It will be the starting frame and source address and destination address and admin data error check and at the ending frame. This is the frame format. It will be there. The frame, it will be forwarded with the data, actual data, to the network layer. The network layer, it receives this actual data and makes them into packets, right? This is the actual data of data link layer, right? And the data link layer program will handle moving the data over the physical devices in the network and determines how devices recover from collisions and errors, sending resend the frames if there is an error, and framing control, and the network layer encapsulating them into frames and addressing the layer 2 mechanism. And synchronization, it is a process of valid frames transmitting and sender and receiver. So the error control and detecting and controlling the errors and retransmitting the frames whenever it is required. So the flow control, it is a control that allows two stations working with the same speed, how the sender will send the message and the receiver will receive the frames and acknowledgement from receiver to the sender, and multi-access, multiple access, it is a sender will send to the information to the receivers multiple stations to access the same information simultaneously. It's like a broadcasting the information, a radio broadcasting, right? It is an announcement in the railway station, right? One time announcement, all will hear the message by the announcer in the railway station. It's like a same thing, right? And in the radio communication, radio will communication will announce radio's voice, it will be notified to all the radio stations, right? It is a multiple access, multi-access control. Multiple stations can access the information simultaneously is called what? Multi-access or multiple access control.